Welcome to the Disturbance, hosted by Dave DeVos.
It's Thursday, October 15th, 2020, and you have turned into the Daily Disturbance. Now, coming up on the big show today, I've got Ty Lue actually signing to be the new head coach of the Los Angeles Clippers. I'll give you my thoughts and opinions on that one. Speaking of finding a new home, Doc Rivers has one, and in search of a home, like today's episode is all about finding a new home. In search of finding a new home is Le'Veon Bell, who has reportedly narrowed it down to three teams that he believes will have an opportunity at some point this year to stick it to Adam Gase and the New York Football Jets. I've got all of that, and trust me, a whole lot more coming up on the big show today. Now, I'm Dave DeBaugh. You've tuned into the Daily Disturbance. This is about a 10 to 15 minute show. This is episode number 5. Thanks so much for tuning into it. Now, let's start in the National Basketball Association today, as Ty Lue has just signed a 5-year deal to be the new head coach of the Los Angeles Clippers. Now, I know Ty Lue won a championship in Cleveland, and that in itself is a feat that nobody else in mankind has ever accomplished in Cleveland. That being said, do I really believe that Ty Lue is going to be the kind of coach that can handle this Los Angeles Clipper team? What that basically means is, do I believe Ty Lue is going to find a way to convince Kawhi Leonard that the regular season and team chemistry actually matters? Because without that, we're going to have a rinse and repeat moment. That's right, Los Angeles Clipper fans. You're going to have a rinse and repeat moment as to what happened in the NBA bubble during the playoffs this past year. So Ty Lue's got a lot in front of him to overcome. I think what we're actually going to find out is if Ty Lue is really a good coach, or if LeBron James is really just that great. Now, speaking of the Los Angeles Clippers and former coaches of the Los Angeles Clippers, Doc Rivers has found a new home, and he will be sitting on that Philadelphia 76er bench. He'll be an assistant coach with the 76ers. One of the really good guys in basketball is Doc Rivers. We'll see how this actually works out for the Philadelphia 76ers, but this is a safe place for Doc to go at this point. Now, we also have this hot story of where would Le'Veon Bell go? And you know that what Le'Veon Bell really wants more than anything is to figure out how he can stick it to the New York Football Jets. Now, I'm just going to give you the top level thing here. The Jets are on the hook for up to $6 million in salary this year. So if, for example, the Kansas City Chiefs sign Le'Veon Bell to a minimum contract, which would be $850,000 for Le'Veon Bell, the New York Football Jets at that point would be on the hook for the other basic, you know, $5.2 million. So that's one way Le'Veon gets to stick it to the New York Football Jets. He gets to make them pay most of his salary wherever he goes in the National Football League. The second way he gets to make the New York Jets pay is by picking a team that actually has a chance to play the Jets this year. And guess what? The three teams that Le'Veon Bell is currently looking at are the Miami Dolphins, the Buffalo Bills, and of course, the Kansas City Chiefs. Now, the latest at the time we recorded this particular show, we had Le'Veon Bell seeming to be closer to signing a deal with the Kansas City Chiefs or the Miami Dolphins. All right. So what does that mean for either of these teams? Well, look, for Kansas City, they don't really need him but he doesn't really cost that much. They've got a strong enough culture where they can handle it. If he goes to Miami, he can resume his rapping career. Because that's a big thing that Le'Veon Bell did during his offseason. You know, he hung out on yachts, made music videos, drank lots of champagne, ate a bunch of caviar. He played that whole rapper video game, and he did that in Miami. So the question is, if Le'Veon signs with the Dolphins, will the Dolphins really get a Le'Veon Bell that wants to play football? Or will they get a Le'Veon Bell that really just wants to be on a yacht that happens to have a recording studio below the deck? That is the big question. All right. Thanks so much for tuning in to the big Daily Disturbance. The shows are usually 10 to 15 minutes in length. Please go ahead and subscribe to the show when you have a chance. Also, do check out our big sports website at mighty.rip. We've got our National Football League power rankings on there for week number 6. And I can tell you that the Cleveland Browns have found a way into our top 10. I know that's painful, but it's true. The Cleveland Browns have entered the top 10 of the mighty top 10 power rankings for week number 6. So check out our big website at mighty.rip. Also coming up this week, we've got our Gods of Odds show, which will be debuting on Friday. It's our weekly look at the top 10 games worth spending some money on. So stay tuned to the Mighty Rip YouTube channel for that. For the Daily Disturbance, I am Dave DeBaugh, wishing you all a fantastic rest of your sports day.